There are many manufacturers of programmable logic controllers that are used in the automation industry. One of the leading PLC manufacturers in the world is ABB. In the previous video, I introduced you to the various PLC models that make up the AC500 product line, the wide range of I/O cards, interfaces, and modules available, and the powerful Automation Builder software. I will now configure a small ABB AC500 PLC system to demonstrate how the components I introduced in the introductory video are connected. I will define a small system that will include a CPU and interfaces for Profibus DP and Ethernet. The CPU will be located in a cabinet in the main automation equipment room. I will require 24-volt DC I/O with one digital input card, one digital output card, and one analog input card, located remotely from the CPU in an I/O panel located in the process area. Additionally, I will include one CP600 operator control panel that will also be mounted in the process area. This HMI will provide the operator access to the process through a touchscreen interface. I consult the latest ABB PLC automation catalog to learn more about the hardware offered in the AC500 product line and the specifications for each device. First, I select a CPU that will be able to handle the communication interfaces and the small number of I/O points in my system. I choose the PM583 ETH CPU, which comes with 1 megabyte of memory, one Ethernet port, and two serial ports. I choose a TB511 terminal base to support the CPU's Ethernet port and to provide one additional communication card slot for a Profibus DP communication card. I select a CM592 DP Profibus DP master communication card to fit next to the CPU in the terminal base. This Profibus interface has a standard 9-pin Profibus connector and supports baud rates from a 9.6 kilobits per second to a 12 megabits per second communication rate. To support the three I/O cards in a remote configuration, I first need a Profibus interface card in the I/O panel to communicate with the CM592 DP card on the CPU terminal base. I select a CI541 DP Profibus card and a TU509 terminal unit base. I will need three TU518 I/O bases, one for a single DI524 32.24-volt DC digital input card, one for a DO526 8.24-volt DC digital output card, and one for an AI523 16-point analog input card. To finish the hardware setup, I will select a CP6615 operator control panel with an Ethernet port. This panel has a 15-inch touchscreen and high-definition resolution. I will connect this HMI to the Ethernet port on the PM583 PLC. I open the Automation Builder software to add the CPU to a new project, which I name Small System. I double-click on the AC500 template icon. When the new project window appears, I select PM583 ETH from the selection list, and then I press Add PLC. I right-click on the PLC and select Edit Object. I then select the PM583 ETH Hardware tab in the Configuration window, and I select the TB511 terminal base from the drop-down list. I select Change PMTB Type and acknowledge the warning message. I now create the Profibus segment by right-clicking on slot 1 under Extension Bus and select Add Object. When the Replace Object window opens, I select the CM592 DP Profibus Master Card, and then I select Replace Object. The Profibus card now appears in the device tree. I right-click on Profibus Master and select Add Object. In the Add Object window, I select the CI541 DP card, and then I select Add Object. The device tree updates and shows the CI541 module. I right-click on the CI541 DP device and select Add Object. I select AI523, the analog input card from the device list, and select Add Object. I repeat this process to add the DI524 digital input card and the DO526 digital output card. I now see all of the hardware components listed in the device tree. Now, I need to add the HMI panel to the hardware configuration. I right-click on the project name, Small System, and select Add Object. In the Add Object window, I select Panel CP600 in the left pane to filter the device list, and then select CP600 Control Panel from the list. I double-click on Panel CP600 in the device tree, and when the information window appears, I see the connection from the CP600 to the CPU is selected by default. The hardware is now ready, and the PLC and operator panel can be programmed to meet the requirements of my project. The PLC is programmed with the Automation Builder software. And the control panel is programmed with a software application called Panel Builder 600. This video has provided a basic understanding of the features and capabilities of the ABB AC500 family of PLCs and hardware. Once you understand the requirements for your process, choosing the right AC500 PLC, communication interfaces, and I/O modules should be no problem. Want to learn PLC programming in an easy-to-understand format and take your career to the next level? Head on over to realpars.com.